Good morning, dear children. Hope all are safe, staying at home. Now in the last class, hope to the valley of flowers. Hope all have read the lesson well, copied all the notes and studied it also. Now we move on to the next lesson. That is a poem, a very small poem, The Eagle. Haven't you all seen the eagle, children? It is called the king of the birds. Now the eagle is a very beautiful bird, isn't it? Very strong bird. When we see it itself, we can see that it is a very powerful one also. And where does the eagle live? Always the eagle, they make their home on the top of the mountains or the top of the hills. Now in this, Alfred Lord Tennyson is talking about the eagle. The eagle, he clasped the crag with crooked hands, close to the sun in lonely lands, ringed with the azure world he stands. The wrinkled sea beneath him crawls, he watches from his mountain walls, and like a thunderbolt he falls. Just 6 lines only. Now look at the first line. He clasped the crag with crooked hands. Now what is the meaning of crag, children? It is a steep rocky surface here on the top of the mountain or hill. And he is clasping. Clasping means holding very tightly with crooked hands. Are your hands crooked or straight? Yes. Haven't you seen the eagle's hands, the claws? We say the claws of the eagle. It is always crooked, not at all straight, not at all even. Close to the sun in lonely lands. Close to the sun means what the poet is telling, that the eagle flies high. That means he is close to the sun. You see the eagle from the top of the mountain, when he is flying high up in the air, we feel that the eagle is very close to the sun. And when he is flying very high, the earth below looks very lonely. There are some places where there are no population at all, or very thin population. Thin population means what? Not much people living in that area. So when the eagle is flying from very top, he feels, the poet feels, that down below the earth is deserted area where there is no population. It is very lonely. The places are very lonely. And ringed with the azure world he stands. What is the meaning of ringed with the azure world? That means surrounded by the blue sky. He is flying up in the air. So he is also surrounded by the blue sky, the poet says. And the wrinkled sea beneath him crawls. Wrinkled sea. Haven't you seen the sea, children? Always the waves of the sea you can see. So the surface of the sea is not at all calm. It is always wrinkled. Wrinkled means folded. When you get up early in the morning, your bed will be all wrinkled. Your bed sheet will all be wrinkled, isn't it? And when you get up, don't you make your bed? Don't you pull the sheet and make it neat and clean? So just like that, the poet says the surface of the sea is always wrinkled, and the sea, the water in the sea is crawling. That means it is moving very, very slowly because the sea is wrinkled beneath. The wrinkled sea beneath him crawls. He watches from his mountain walls. Mountain walls means the top of the mountain, the place where he is taking rest, his home, the eagle's home. And like a thunderbolt he falls. What is that? Like a thunderbolt he falls. So the eagle sits on top of the mountain or very top place, and he is watching down. What all things are there down? Whether he can catch a baby chicken or a frog or a mice or anything else for its food. So as soon as he sees that there is some food for him down on the earth, what does he do? He comes down very quickly. He swoops down from the mountain top to come and catch its prey. That is the meaning. And like a thunderbolt he falls. His coming down from the mountain top is compared to thunder. Thunder and lightning. You remember when the thunder and lightning strikes, there will be a very great sound. It's very dangerous also. Same way, the eagle is very dangerous when it is coming down to catch its prey. So, read the poem well, children. Now, we go to exercise A. Tick the correct options. The phrase crooked hands refers to A. long nails, B. bent hands, C. the clawed feet, and D. beak and claws. So, first one, clawed feet. C is the answer. Then 2, the azure world refers to A. the earth, B. the sea, C. the sky, and D. the land. It is also C. the sky. Third one, in the poem, the eagle comes across as A. lonely, B. proud, C. helpless, and D. powerful. So, in the poem it is D. powerful. And the fourth one, the phrase like a thunderbolt he falls refers to A. the thunderstorm during the eagle's flight, B. the sound of thunder, C. the swift and direct way the eagle swoops down, and D. the eagle falling from the sky like lightning. It is C. the swift and direct way the eagle swoops down. Now B is answer these questions with reference to the context. Close, number one, close to the sun in lonely lands. How is the eagle close to the sun? Now the poet tells us that the eagle is close to the sun. How is that so? You remember the eagle is flying high in the air, very high. So the poet says, gives us a picture that the eagle is flying very high, so it is close to the sun. Now B, what does lonely lands refer to? I told you, when the eagle is flying from a very great height and when he looks down, the poet is telling that there are not much people down there, living there. Sometimes there will be places where there are no people at all, or desert areas. So the eagle, when it flies high above the air, he feels that the down, the earth is very lonely. 2. The wrinkled sea beneath him crawls. A. Why does the sea seem wrinkled? The sea looks wrinkled because the waves are always keep moving the water in the sea. The waves are always moving. So the water is also moving. It is not at all standing still. It is not at all calm. It seems wrinkled or folded. Haven't you gone to the beach? Haven't you watched the sea? Especially when the waves are coming, it looks, the waves come like this, so the water will be not calm. Why does it seem to be crawling? Now, why does it seem to be crawling? Being from a great, number two, the wrinkled sea beneath him crawls. Now, why does it seem to be crawling? It is because the movement of the water, because of the waves keeping on, makes the water rolling. And so the poet thinks that the water is not moving at all. It is only crawling and going, just like a reptiles. They crawl and go. The lizard, the snake, it's moving very, very slowly. So the third one, he watches from his mountain walls. A. What or whom does the eagle watch? Now, what does the eagle watch, children? The eagle, he is watching from the resting place. The mountain walls means he is watching from his resting place. And what is he watching? He is watching whether there is any food down on the earth. When he can come fall down, he can come swooping down and catch its prey. What does mountain walls refer to? Mountain walls refers to the resting place of the eagle. The eagle always makes the home on top of the mountains or hills. So the mountain wall is the resting place where he is looking for his food. Now we stop here, children. We'll continue in the next class. Thank you.